there. Welcome to my curls. Today's video is going to be about the perks of being in your 40s. And y'all, I know I love to talk about my gray hair. And having gray hair kind of comes along with age. And I want to talk about how you can accept your gray hair and accept the fact that you're aging. And there are some really great things that come along with being in your 40s. I'm 48. I'm going to be turning 49 in a couple of months. And so I'm in my late 40s. And when I was younger, my mother would always say, I don't want to be 40 or I don't want to be 50. And I always just thought it was old or it was a bad thing to be or somewhere that I didn't want to go. But now that I'm here, honestly, there are some really great things about being in your 40s, and so that's what I want to share with you in this video. Now, this video is going to have two parts. Part one is going to be about the perks of being in your 40s, and part two is going to be about some of the not so great things about being in your 40s. So stay tuned for that one coming out soon. So if you're new to my channel, my name is Renee, and I love to talk about my gray hair. Y'all have been going gray for a long time now, and like I said, I am 48 years old. I want to talk about aging, and I want to talk about really just embracing your age and accepting the fact that you are getting older, because there are some really great things about getting older, and I feel like we don't talk about those great things enough. So I'm going to share them with you. This is my perspective on getting older, and like I said, I'm getting ready to turn 49. So here we go. The perks of being in your 40s. One of the number one things that I have learned about being in my 40s is I don't let anybody else influence me. I don't give in to peer pressure. I don't even really pay attention to what others are doing. I'm not trying to be one of the cool kids anymore. And I never really was one of the cool kids growing up, to be honest. But I don't really care what all the cool ladies are out doing anymore. I just do what suits me. And I don't give in to peer pressure. I don't give in to the way that I see others being or acting or talking and like the cool words and the hip words that my teenage daughters use and like the crop tops and all that stuff. I just don't do it. I don't give in to peer pressure. Now, I do try to dress stylish and I do try to be on trend, but it's my version of that trend. It is my 48-year-old, the way I want to dress version of whatever is trendy. So yes, I still wear skinny jeans. Yes, I will wear the colors that are in style at the moment, but I am not going to go out in a crop top or with the back cut out of my shirt or any of the younger trends. What the younger kids are doing doesn't faze me at all. I don't give in to peer pressure. Another thing that's kind of cool in my 40s, I don't know if this is good or bad yet. I haven't quite figured it out, but I've always been an active person. I have always worked out. I was an athlete growing up, even in through college. And so I've always been on a very active and strenuous workout schedule. And even in my early 40s and my mid 40s, I used to go to a hardcore boot camp class. And I mean hardcore. I worked out like a crazy person. And I saw the benefits of that. I had a killer body. I had killer arms. I looked fantastic. But once I hit about 45, that method of working out really started to take a toll on my body physically. My shoulder hurt, my knees would hurt, my ankles hurt, one of my toes would hurt, and my feet hurt. And I just, in the last 5 years, have realized that my body does not need that anymore, and my body cannot adapt to that hardcore style of working out anymore. And so, about 6 months ago, I stopped doing that. I now prefer stretching, I like yoga, I love Pilates, I love to just get outside and walk by myself because I love to think while I'm walking, walk my dogs. I just don't need the high impact, the cardio, the jumping. I just don't want to do it anymore. So I don't. I do what my body tells me to do. I do what makes me happy. And it's really just about strength training and stretching and just being in a happy place. And yoga is great for that. And walking, just being outside. I don't need to go to the gym anymore. I feel and do like hardcore lifting with weights and cardio and jumping jacks and burpees and jumping lunges. I just don't need to do it anymore. And the last year or two that I actually stayed in my boot camp class, I did a modified version of all of those high impact exercises because they just did not feel good to me anymore. I did not enjoy them, and so I stopped doing them. Something else that is really great about being in your 40s is you learn how to say no. Now, I know I hear people say that over and over, learn how to say no, but I was never really able to do that until I was in my 40s. If somebody asks me to do something and I really don't want to do it, I just don't give in to them anymore and say, well, okay. I just say, I'm sorry, I can't, or I'm busy, or I have something else planned, or I'm not going to be able to work that in my schedule. I just say no. I don't have time or desire to spend my time doing something that I don't want to do, or I'm not with the people that I want to be with. So I simply say no. Another great thing that is so fantastic about being in your 40s is I am financially stable. There's just something about once you hit your 40s, things just kind of even out. And even if there are some moments when I'm worried about finances, I really don't get that worked up about it. It will all just be fine. And I kind of know that now. I've learned that over the years. I'm a saver. I'm not a spender. I have never been one to just go out and buy things. I like my money in my bank account, and I like my money to work for me. If there's something I want, or if there's something I want to do, if I want to travel, then I will certainly spend money. But I am not one to go shopping, to just buy random things. It just, I prefer my money in my bank account. It is very nice to know that I'm financially secure and financially stable. It is a wonderful feeling. And once I hit my 40s, my early 40s, I decided that I was going to dress exactly how I wanted to. And by that, I mean comfortable. It blows my mind because I can see women that are way older than me running around town, going in the grocery store in their workout, skin-tight yoga pants with their booty hanging out. If I'm going to work out, certainly I'll put on my yoga pants. But if I'm home, I don't want to wear those. They are not comfortable. And anybody that says that they are comfortable, they are lying to themselves. Workout clothes are meant for workouts, not for wearing around your house, lounging around your house, and certainly not for working from home, which is what we are all doing right now. So when I am home, I'm in my comfy clothes. I'm either in my pajama pants, I'm in jogging pants, I'm actually in some little capri, like athletic stretchy pants right now, and I love them. I'm gonna wear a sports bra when I'm at home or a bralette. I stopped wearing underwire bras years ago because I hated them. They made me uncomfortable, and I'm just not gonna do it anymore. And let's just talk about shoes. I gave up wearing high-heeled shoes about 10 years ago. I learned that if my feet are unhappy, I am really unhappy. So I do not wear heels ever. I don't even think that I own any heels. In the summertime, I am all about some sandals and some flats and some flip-flops. And even in the wintertime, I have boots with, like, you know, just a little teeny heel on them. But this 3-inch high heel, uncomfortable, clomping around everywhere heel that I still see women wearing, that is not for me, y'all, and I know it, and I don't do it. I wear what I want, I dress to be comfy, and that is what makes me happy. And that goes back to, I don't care what anybody else thinks, and I don't give in to peer pressure. So if the trend is high heel shoes or high heel boots, I'm just not gonna be in on that trend. And in my 40s, I have really learned to trust my instincts. My gut feeling, my instinct, I had a friend who used to call it his spidey sense. I really trust my spidey sense. When I meet somebody new or I'm in a situation or something's going on and I just get this gut feeling that something's off, I really have learned to trust that feeling and know that I'm generally correct and to get out of the situation, back up from the situation, distance myself from that person or whatever it is. I've just really learned to trust my instincts and they generally do not fail me. When I turned 30, I really thought that I had figured out who I was. And then as I got in later into my 30s, well, I thought I just had this all figured out. I knew exactly who I was and the person that I wanted to be. That turned out to be not so true. Once I hit my 40s, then I really figured out who I am and the kind of person that I want to be and the kind of life I want to live. And in my 40s, I know exactly who I am and I am comfortable being me. Completely, 100% comfortable being me. And that kind of plays into my gray hair. I think in order to go gray, you do have to be comfortable with yourself. You have to know who you are. You have to be confident enough to kind of go through this transition, the growing out process of gray hair. And I really know who I am at this point, and I am certainly comfortable being myself. And that's why I've been able to embrace my gray hair, to embrace all of the bad looks and the bad hair days that I've had to get here. And today is even not a fantastic hair day. It has been a beautiful week here where I live. I have been outside for the past 3 days power washing all of our concrete. I love a power washer. It is so satisfying to just blow off all of that like mold and dirt and the dark that's kind of accumulated on things over the winter. I love to do it every spring. So for the past 3 days, I've been power washing. Today it turned out really cold, and so I can't go outside, which is where I love to be. But I took a shower yesterday because I was covered in mud. I washed my hair, but I really didn't fix it. And today I knew I was just going to be at home. I have nowhere to go. I'm just kind of chilling today. And I didn't want to fix my hair, but I'm confident enough in myself to be able to go and make a video and put it out for the world to see on YouTube with not a fantastic hairdo today. And I'm in my comfy clothes. Another great thing about being in your 40s is if I don't want to do something, I don't do it. There are things that growing up, I always felt like I needed to be a part of. I needed to go to the party in college. I needed to go to the get-together that my friends were having, or the backyard barbecue, or the bonfire. I needed to go to the big New Year's Eve party and dress up in some dress. I'm going to be honest, I hated all of it. I was never a person that liked being around strangers or being in big crowds. I was always more comfortable being with a very small group of close friends or people that I enjoyed being around. That fraternity, partying in college, I hated it. I did it, but I hated it. And now that I'm in my 40s and all of that is still going on and we get invited to do things, I just say no because I don't want to do it. I don't enjoy it. And so I don't do something I don't want to do. The next thing about being in your 40s is something very exciting. And I have two daughters, one that's 21. She's getting ready to be a senior in college. And then I have my youngest daughter who is a senior in high school who is supposed to be graduating in another month if they're allowed to have graduation. So I am just a couple of months away from being an empty nester. I cannot believe it that there are going to be no children at home. I love my daughters. I love it when they're here. I'm going to miss them dearly when they're gone. But there is something very exciting about knowing that my husband and I are going to be home alone. And it's just that I don't have my daughter's schedules to dictate my life anymore. I get to do me and my schedule and what I want to do. I don't have to get them to theater rehearsal or to cheerleading practice or ball games or pick up from school. I don't have to make their lunches anymore. Just all of my world is suddenly going to be freed up. And even things as simple as, right now, I cannot even back out of my garage because my daughter's car is in the driveway behind me. I have to maneuver my way around her car to get anywhere. So when she's gone to college, her car will be gone with her and I can back out. There are just so many little exciting things that I'm looking forward to about having an empty nest. And I still get to see my girls. I still talk to them every day. I FaceTime my oldest daughter who's away at school all the time. She comes home to visit, but my life kind of becomes my own life again. And I am looking forward to that. And in my 40s, I realized that I really love to learn. You know, when you're growing up and you're in school and you're in college and you're forced to learn, that is your job, to learn. It just takes on its own life. I didn't love learning because I had to learn. Well, now that I'm in my 40s, I want to learn. There are so many things that I want to do and I want to learn about. And my YouTube channel is the perfect example. When I started this channel, I didn't know anything about YouTube. I didn't know how to record a video. I didn't know how to edit a video. I did not know how to do graphics. I didn't know how to talk to you on camera. I knew none of those things. And I have really, really enjoyed the process of learning how to do videos and all of the things that go along with it. And so it's kind of broadened my horizons. There are more graphics things that I want to learn, more editing tricks that I want to learn. There's just so much that I want to do with what I've learned on my YouTube channel that you all are going to benefit from. But in my 40s, I've learned that I like to learn. I love to read. I'm now reading some social media marketing books, not textbooks, but books where you learn things, not just flat out fiction. And it's been kind of nice. I love to learn. Being in my 40s has freed me up so that I can enjoy learning instead of being forced to have to learn. And one fantastic perk about being in my 40s is having the ability to travel when I want to. When I was younger and my kids were younger, if I wanted to go on vacation or if I wanted to take a weekend trip, it was almost impossible to get that done. I had to have somebody either come to the house and take care of the kids, or I had to pawn the girls off on grandmothers or aunts or my sister or somebody to take care of the children and the dogs. Somebody had to take care of our house, the dogs, the kids. Well, I don't have to do that anymore because we are going to be empty nesters and our daughters are old enough to take care of themselves. If Randy and I want to go on vacation, if we want to be gone for a week or 2 weeks or a weekend or overnight or whatever it is, I can do it in a moment's notice. And that is wonderful. So if you're in your 40s or 50s or 60s, I would love to hear from you. Comment below and let me know, what did you realize about yourself in your 40s? What were some of the main perks that you found about hitting your 40s? I would love for all of the ladies who are on my channel that are in their late 30s or mid 30s, who are going gray, and that's why you're watching my videos, to really just think ahead. Think about being in your 40s. Look at all of the great things that happen when you're in your 40s and enjoy looking forward. Just know that there are some great things to come as you age and enjoy the aging process. I think the older I've gotten, the better life has gotten. And when I was in my 20s, I thought life was pretty stinking great. But now that I'm older, I realize life is so much better. I did not know what I was doing in my 20s. I did not know who I was when I was in my 20s. Well, now that I'm in my 40s and I'm able to look back, I truly think life gets better as you age. And I wish that that thought could really just be portrayed to the younger kids. But I hope you enjoyed my video. I would love to hear from you in the comments below. And until next time, I'll see you later.